Exception handling allows us to deal with unexpected situations that may occur in our program. As an example, we'll pick opening a file using the StreamReader class in the System I/O namespace. To see what kind of exceptions this class may throw, we can hover the cursor over the class name. If any one of these were to occur, the program will be terminated. To avoid this, we must catch the exceptions using a try-catch statement. This statement consists of a try block containing the code that may cause the exception and one or more catch clauses. If the try block executes successfully, it will then continue running after the catch blocks. But if an exception occurs, execution will be passed to the first catch block able to handle that exception. Since this catch block is not set to handle any specific exception, it will catch all of them. This is equivalent to catching the System Exception class, because all exceptions derive from this class. If we want to catch a more specific exception, we need to place that catch block before more general exceptions. The catch block can optionally define an exception object that we can use to obtain more information about the exception, such as a description of the error. As the last clause in the try-catch statement, we can add a finally block. This block is used to clean up resources allocated in the try block and will always execute whether there is an exception or not. In this case, we should close the file that we opened in the try block, but only if it was successfully opened. To be able to access the StreamReader object from here, we must declare it outside of the try block. If we forget to close the stream, the garbage handler will eventually do it for us, but we should remember to do it ourselves. When a situation occurs that we cannot recover from, we can generate our own exceptions to signal to the caller that the method has failed. This is done using the throw keyword, followed by a new instance of an exception class. The exception will then propagate up to the caller, where we can catch it. If the caller is not able to recover from the error, we can rethrow it using only the throw keyword. The program will now stop executing, since there are no more try-catch statements, and will display the error message.